Today we're going to work in section 4.2. And in section 4.2, you're getting introduced to logarithmic functions. And we're going to be talking about the basic stuff dealing with logarithmic functions, and then we're going to get into graphing them. And then when we get into section 4.3, you're going to build on it. Section 4, you build a little more with logarithmics and exponentials. But in section 4.2, the first thing that we're going to look at here is we want to talk about logarithmic form and exponential form. Now, again, this section deals with logarithmic functions. This section deals with logarithmic functions. Now, what we're going to talk about first, and we're going to define logs and stuff a little bit later on, but what I want us to start with is I want us to look at the logarithmic form and an exponential form here. So you can see how they match up, I guess is a good word, how they interchange. When we have logarithmic form, this is read the log of b to the base a equals c. The log of b to the base a equals c. Now you can also read it log base a of b equals c. They mean the same thing here. Log of b to the base a, log base a of b. You're taking the log of b to the base of a here. Does everybody see this? This is logarithmic form. This logarithm here, written in exponential form, would be a to the c equals b. This is the logarithmic form of this exponential form. This exponential form is of this logarithmic form. Does everybody follow me? Now, when we're in the logarithmic form, this is your base. That pen's about had it. Notice how it's the base over here. Does everybody see that? Those are both your base here. All right. What do you notice about this right here? What is C when it comes over here? C becomes the what? Exponent. So C over here is the exponent. When you're rewriting from logarithmic, you go base to power equals what you're taking the log of. Look, base to power equals what I'm taking the log of. Does everybody see that? So, for example, if I were to have the log of 8 to the base 2 equals 3. How can I rewrite this in exponential form? What's your base here? 2 to the what's the power? 3 equals, what am I taking the log of? 8. And isn't that true? Isn't 2 cubed going to be 8 here? All right, let's say we had this one. The log of 1/9 to the base 3 equals negative 2. So what's my base over here? 3, what's my power? Negative 2, and what's this equal? 1/9. So are y'all starting to see going from logarithmic to exponential here? All righty. Let's say we had this one. 1/2 equals the log base 2 of square root of 2. Now, what is your base right here? 2. What's my power? 1/2. And what's that got to equal? Square root of 2. Does everybody see this? Okie doke. Is everybody okay here? Questions? All right. What about if we had this one? Y'all write this one in exponential for me. The log of, let's say, 81 to the base 3 equals 4. Rewrite that in exponential for me. All right, so is everybody okay here? What'd you get? 3 to the 4th equals 81. So does everybody understand how to go from logarithmic form to exponential form? Is everybody okay there? Question. All right, now let's go from exponential form to logarithmic form. What we want to do now is we want to go from exponential form back to logarithmic form. Now, remember that when we had our logarithmic form, log b, the base a equals c, your base was a, your power is c, and that equals b. So now we want to go backwards here. We're going from exponential to logarithmic. So if I have this, 4 to the negative 3 equals 1 over 64. 4 to the negative 3 equals 1 over 64. Then I'm going to write this as the log, what's my base? 4 of 1 over 64, because where does your power have to go? Remember, it's going to go over here, isn't it? And how could you check yourself? Base to power. 4 to the negative 3 equals what I'm taking the log of. Does everybody see this? Okay, y'all do this one. Now let me do one more. Square root of 3 equals 3 to the 1/2. So now, what's your base here? What's your base? 3. What's your power? 1/2, and it's going to have to equal what? Square root of 3. I'm trying to get you to see it doesn't matter how they write it. Your base here is still what? 3. Your exponent's 1/2. All right, now y'all do these. I'm going to give you two to do. Write these in logarithmic form. Two to the 4th equals 16, and let's see, I'm going to see if y'all can do this one. Cube root of 8 equals 2. Now that one's a little tricky, but I'm going to let you see if you can figure it out.
the first one here.
This would be the log, what's your base? 2. Your power, 4 goes over here, and 16 goes here, right? Now, this one was tricky. What's your base here? 8. And what's your power? 1/3, and that equals 2. Now, this one got a little tricky because this cube root of 8 is the same thing as 8 to the 1/3, isn't it? Is it the cube root of 8 the same thing as 8 to the 1/3? If you'll remember back from some of your math gone by, if you've got the mth root of, actually we usually write it this way, the nth root of a to the m, that's the same thing as a to the m over n. So 1 over 3. Does everybody remember that? So are we okay with these? All right, the next thing we want to talk about is something called a common logarithm and something called a natural logarithm. We want to talk about a common logarithm and a natural logarithm. A common logarithm, this is a logarithm that has a base of 10. And how we write that is just the log of whatever there. A common logarithm has an understood base of 10. A common logarithm has an understood base of 10. So if you ever see just log without a base, it's got an understood base of 10. This is your log key on the calculator. The log key on the calculator, that is the common logarithm. Is everybody with me there? Now, a natural logarithm, this is a logarithm with a base of e. And how we write that is ln of x. And the reason why they don't do the nl is because if they did nl, then that starts looking like a 1. All right? So this is an understood base of what? You've got an understood base of e. This is that ln key on your calculator. That is the natural logarithm. So does everybody see the natural logarithm here? And the common logarithm. So whenever you see ln, you know it's a natural logarithm and it's got an understood base of e. Whenever you see log without a base, it's got an understood base of 10. That's a common logarithm. Now, your properties of logarithms, let's talk about these next. Your properties of logarithms, and these are just a few because we're going to get more of these. Now, what I've done here, I'm giving them to you with any general base. Here, base of, what's this right here? What type of logarithm is this? Common logarithm with a base of 10, and this is a natural logarithm with a base of what? E. What do you notice? Anytime you take the log of 1, regardless of what the base is, what is it always going to equal? 0. The log of 1 will always be 0. Does everybody see that? Here, when you take the log of something and it's the same as your base, see the log of b to the base b is going to be 1. What's your understood base right here? 10. So the log of 10 to the base 10 is 1. What's your understood base on the natural log? E. So the natural log of e to the base e is 1. So whenever what you're taking the log of is the exact same as your base, what's that going to equal? 1. Does everybody see this property? The next one here, when you've got the log of b to the x to the base b, now what do you notice? Your bases are the same, aren't they? You've got a base b, and here I've got a base of b to the x. When your bases are the same, what's that going to equal? Whatever the exponent is. All right, what's your base right here understood? 10 and 10 are the same, so it's going to equal x. What's your understood base here? E, so what are you going to get here? X. Now, your inverse properties that I've put up here. Your inverse properties. B to the log of x to the base b. What do you notice about your bases here? They're the same, so it's going to equal what you're taking the log of here. What's your understood base and the exponent up here? 10. Your bases are the same, so it's going to equal x. What's your understood base up here in the exponent? E. So your bases are the same, so it's going to equal x. For example, on these, if I have 8 to the log of 4x to the base 8, what does that equal? 4x. Can't get any easier than that. That's it. Because what do you notice? Base 8 is going to equal 4x. All right? What about one for this one? If I had 10 to the log of x squared, what's your understood base here? 10. So your 10s are the same, so this one would just equal what? X squared. If I have e to the natural log of, say, x cubed, what's this got to equal? X cubed, because your base is E and your base there is E. That's all those inverses are. That's how easy those are. Is everybody okay there with the inverses? All right. Because the reason why you need to know all this is what we're going to do now is we're going to evaluate some logarithms. We're going to evaluate some logarithms. For example, if I have the log of 81 to the base 3. And I'm going to zoom back out so y'all can see it. And hopefully it'll zoom. Okay. Log of 81 to the base 3. To evaluate this, the first thing we're going to do is we're going to set it equal to x. We're going to set this equal to x. So I have the log of 81 to the base 3 equals x. Now, what form is this right here in? This is in logarithmic, isn't it? I want to rewrite it in exponential. So this would be 3 to the x equals 81. Does everybody see I've rewritten this in exponential form? Is everybody okay there? Now once you do this, once you get it in exponential, you want to get the same base on both sides. Now listen to me, you want to get the same base on both sides. Well, what is your base over here? 3. So I need to get 81 to a base of 3. So what I recommend you do is go to the side somewhere. 3 to the 0 is 1. 3 to the 1st is 3. 3 squared is 9. 3 cubed is 27. 3 to the 4th is 81. So how can I rewrite 81 with the base of 3? 3 to the 4th. So 3 to the x is equal to 3 to the 4th power. Now, again, you want to get both sides to the same base. Now, are my bases the same? Aren't your bases the same? Well, if your bases are the same and this thing's equal, then what has to be true about your exponents? They have to be equal. So what is the log of 81 to the base 3 equal to? 4, because we said x would have to be 4 here.
Isn't that pretty cool? Does everybody follow on this one? All right, let's say we had this problem. The log of the square root of 3 to the base 3. What do I do first with this? Set it equal to x, right? So is everybody with me to there? Now what do? Rewrite it in exponential. So 3 to the x equals the square root of 3. Now how can you rewrite the square root of 3? 3 to what power? Very good, the 1/2. Remember, if you've got the square root of a, that's a to the 1/2 power, isn't it? So the square root of 3 is 3 to the 1/2. So what's x have to equal here? 1/2. So the log of square root of 3 to the base 3 has to equal 1/2. So how are y'all doing? Starting to see this a little bit? Takes a little practice. All right, let's do another one here. Let's say we had this time. Let's see if I can fit this one on the bottom here. The log of 64 to the base of 32. So I've got the log of 64 to the base of 32, and I'm going to set this equal to x. So now, if I rewrite this in exponential, what's your base? 32 to the x equals 64. Can I get both sides to a base of 8? Well, let's see. 8 to the 0 is 1. What's 8 to the first? 8. What's 8 squared? 64. I do not have a 32 in there, so I can't use 8, can I? All right, let's try 4. 4 to the 0 is 1. 4 squared is 16. And what is 4 cubed? 64. Again, what am I missing there? 32. So now I want to try what? 2. 2 to the 0 is 1. 2 to the first is 2. 2 squared is 4. 2 cubed is 8. 2 to the 4th is 16. 2 to the 5th is 32. And 2 to the 6th is what? 64. So I've got my 32 and my 64. 32 is 2 to what power? The 5th. And 64 is 2 to the 6th. Now, is everybody with me to there? You kind of see the process you have to go to get both sides to the same base here. Now, what do you do right here? What's 5 times x? 5x. Now, are my bases equal? Yes. Yeah, so what has to be true about my powers? They have to equal. And if I divide by 5, what do I get for x here? 6/5. So what is the log of 64... to the base of 32 equal to? Six fifths. Isn't this pretty cool? Is everybody doing all right? Everybody okay here? Now, let's say we had this one. Let's say that we have the log of 164, 1 over 64, to the base 4. Now again, the first thing we're going to do is set this equal to what? X, and 4 to the x equals 1 over 64. Now you could use 2, but I can also use what? 4, right? Because 4 to 0 is 1, 4 to the 1st is 4,
4 squared 16, and 4 cubed is 64. Now, this 64 I can write as 4 cubed, right? But I still don't have both sides to the same base, do I? Because this one is a 4, and this is 1/4, isn't it? So if you'll remember that x to the negative n is 1 over x to the n, if I bring this x to the n up, what has to happen to the power? Becomes negative. So this would be 4 to the x equals 4 to the negative 3. Because when I bring this up, what's going to happen to the power? It's going to have to make it what? Negative. So what's x have to equal here? Negative 3. So what is the log of 1 over 64 to the base 4 equal to? Negative 3. Again, guys, what we're doing here, we're evaluating logarithms without using what? Our handy-dandy graphing utility. So we okay with this one? All right, let's say we had this problem. The log of, let's do this one, 0.0001 what am I going to set it equal to? X. What's your understood base right here? So 10 to the x equals 0.001. Now guys, I'm going to write this one again right here because there's two different ways that you can do this one. And I'm going to copy it over right there because I'm going to show you both ways. Is everybody ready? The first way here, if I rewrote this as a fraction, this would be 1 over what? 10,000. Does everybody agree it's 1 over 10,000? Tenths, hundredths, thousandths, ten thousandths. All right, how do you write 10,000 to a base of 10? It's real hard. Count your zeros. It's 10 to the fourth. So now what can you do with that 10 to the fourth? Bring it up. And what's x equal here? Negative 4. So we know that the log of 0.0001 has to equal negative 4, right? Now again, that's one way to do this. How would you write this in scientific notation over here, somebody? Wouldn't this be 1.0 times 10 to the negative what? 4. And what's 1 times 10 to the negative 4? 10 to the negative 4, so what would x have to equal? Negative 4. You could rewrite that back in scientific notation. That one was kind of easy, wasn't it? Is everybody doing all right so far? Okay, let's talk about problems where you can use your rules here. Let's talk about some problems where you would use those properties that I gave you just a minute ago. Take just a minute, and I want everybody to do these 8 problems for me. Applying your properties that we looked at earlier, everybody do these for me. I was going to rewrite them, but I was out of time. All right, the first one. What's the log of 1 always going to be? Regardless of what your base is, it's always going to be 0, is it? What is the natural log of e to the base e? Your bases are the same, so what's this one have to equal? 1, does it? The ln of e to the base e is just going to be 1. All right, what about the next one? Aren't these bases the same, so what's this one have to equal? 1. Here, the natural log of e to the 6. Now again, what's your understood base right there? E, so what's this have to equal? 6. Are my bases the same here? 5 and 5. So what's this one have to equal? 3. This is your inverse. The natural log of x squared to the base e. You got a base e here. So what's this one have to equal? X squared. What about this one? 4x. And what would this one be? So do you see your inverse properties? All right, now guys, there will be a part 2 to this video. All we've got left in section 4.2 is doing your graphing. So there will be a part 2, all right? So continue on to part 2.